this really 100% affordable? In October of 2011. Why? Because the document they had in front of them said 70-unit apartment complex with a component. Right? Remember that term, component? Well, I know I went to Washburn High School. I didn't go to a prep school or anything. But at Washburn, they taught me that a component is the part of a whole. It's not the whole. So how in October could the building have been 100% affordable? Okay? I watched that HRA meeting 10 times, and three different people that night didn't know it was 100% affordable. And they know who they are. So,
just the last thing I'll get out of it, and that is, you know, currently the schedule would have the public hearing for the TIF district on May 22nd. That same schedule currently has the city council considering the rezoning and the planning and development PUD on that night. So everything would be, all of the major decisions would be laid out for you in one night under the current schedule. That's what we've been trying to align these things so they can come to you together. They don't always line up that way, but that's been our endeavor with this.
We're going to get all that plus the public hearing that same night?
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to tell you right now, that's a lot to take in one night.
Well, it's one or the other. It's either you get them separately in a piecemeal, or
you get them together.
I didn't make that
schedule. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I guess one thing that I've heard Councilman Morogi talk about is concerned that he needs time in advance to review things and so forth. But we've also talked about having an HRA hearing in April, I think. Did I hear that?
Correct.
How much of the material that we'll be looking at the City Council in May will be considered at the HRA meeting?
I think it's pretty much the same information. It will be a modification to the TIF plan. And it will be a modification of the Richfield redevelopment project area and the creation of the TIF district. And I think it's going to be the same document that goes to the HRA that comes to you. Yes.
Okay, so that will actually be provided to the council and the HRA in April.
Yeah.
Correct.
So there will be a month in advance, we assume, to take a look at it.
So why are you dealing with the TIF 2 weeks before that?
What's the question?
If the TIF information is all going to be done in April for the HRA, why aren't we dealing with it in the first city council meeting of May?
Because of the way state law states that you have to notice public hearing for the planning or for the city council. One of the concerns is that other taxing jurisdictions are affected by this. The county, the school district, the mosquito control district, whomever. And stringent state laws about you have to provide X number of notice, so we cannot move the council consideration of that any sooner because of the noticing requirements.
But the HRA doesn't help me that same amount.
Correct. That's the state statute. Mm-hmm.
One more time. Just to ask Mr. Clark, I'm assuming that since we have to have most of this material and all of the material basically in April, that when we get it in April, it'll be as far as you can make it a final proposal for that
Richfield, and this is going to the council and planning commission, so it's ready for the record.